Hey buddy, on my last video titled How to Install USB Web Server, I said that there will be a second video, which is this one. This video will show you how to basically install latest version of WordPress. It could be any server. I'll be using USB Web Server in this video, but the process will be same for all other servers. Now let's go to the WordPress website to download it. This is the official website of WordPress. The first link in the description will be to this website. Click on it and you should be at this page. Note that as time goes, some things might change. Mostly the process will be same. If something changes in the procedure, I will make a new video and link it to this video. So here what you will do is click on the download WordPress button at the top. Once you click that, you should be in a page something similar to this. This is the WordPress download page. Here simply click on the download WordPress 4.8.1 button. Note that according to time, the version may change. A dialog similar to this will appear if you are using Mozilla Firefox, but you are free to use any browser you like. Only thing is, you should download this file. The download is approximately 8 megabytes. Once the downloading is completed, navigate to the file. In Mozilla Firefox, you can simply open your downloads and click on this folder icon. Now you will need an archive manager. I'm using WinRAR for this video. You can use 7-zip or WinZip or even any other zip manager you prefer. Once you got that, extract the files from the downloaded zip. If you are using WinRAR, then right-click on the file. Now select extract2/wordpress-4.8.1, or in your case, it should be extract2/filename. It might take a while to extract the files depending upon your computer speed. Please wait while the extraction is finished. Watch out! The floor is lava! Once completed, open the newly created folder named after the downloaded file. There should be another folder named WordPress. Open it by clicking twice on it. This is how the WordPress files look like. Now we need to copy them to the root of the serving folder of your server. If you are using USB Web Server, you should paste these files in the folder called root. If you are using Apache Web Server, then there will be a folder called www where you have to paste these files. For any other server, I will try to link a document in the description listing the serving folders of different servers. Now let's select all of these files and right-click on one of them and select copy. Let's go to the folder named root because I'm using USB Web Server. Now make sure the folder is empty and paste the copied files. For that, right-click on the empty space. Now select paste to paste all the files copied. Once all the files have been pasted, check if your server is running or stopped. If your server is stopped, then start it. Once your server has started serving, just navigate to localhost. If you have a different port configured at your server, then your URL should be localhost:\your port. If you're having a different port for your server, I recommend to set it to 80 as it's the default. If your port is already 80, then typing in localhost is enough. You can close the explorer now. On your internet browser, type the URL. For me, it's localhost. Now you should be at the configuration page of WordPress. Here, select your preferred language and press the continue button. If you're watching this video, I expect you have MySQL database and phpMyAdmin already installed. If you don't know what are these, then please watch some other videos and install MySQL and phpMyAdmin. Good news for people using USB Web Server. MySQL and phpMyAdmin come pre-installed with USB Web Server. So, now you need to know your database name, database username, database password, as well as database host. Assuming that you have both the softwares, let's open phpMyAdmin. For USB Web Server, it's localhost/phpMyAdmin. Now open a new tab. Navigate to phpMyAdmin. Here, type in your username. By default, it might be root. After that, type in your password. If you're using USB Web Server, by default, it will be USBW. If you're using a different server, then enter the password you provided while installing phpMyAdmin. Finally, click on the login button to log in. Once you have opened PHP MyAdmin, create a new database. If you have already done this, you can skip this step. Note that the database should be empty, otherwise you will encounter some errors while using WordPress. To create a database, first click on the Databases menu at the top. In the text box here, type the database name you want to create. In my case, I want to name it Wasn't Developer. I recommend you to not have spaces because it might become a problem while configuring WordPress. After you have typed a name, press the Create button to create a database. As you can see on the left side, the new database has been created. Now you can close this tab. Here on this page, assuming that now you have all the data required, click on Let's Go button. On the first text box, enter the newly created database name or the database name which you want to allocate to WordPress. On the second text box, enter the username. For me, it's root. Enter yours in your WordPress installation. Now enter the password of your database. Here, make sure you enter your database password, not something different. The database host is localhost if you're running this on a local machine. If you're configuring WordPress on a website, then you have to get this from your database hosting provider. A lot of times, your database provider is same as your website provider. In that case, enter localhost here. Now, the table prefix text box is a little bit different. If you want to run two or more WordPress sites on the same database, then you have to change it. Otherwise, leave it as it is. Finally, click on the submit button to let WordPress process our data. Once you see this message, that's it. You are now just one step ahead of installing WordPress. Now click on the Run the Install button. Here, enter your website title on the first text box. Now enter the username which can be used by WordPress. Note that you are creating a new username, so don't enter your database username or something else. Create something new, so it won't be any problem later. After you have entered a proper username, create a password. Note that WordPress will generate a random password for you. You can change it or keep it. Personally, I think the password WordPress generates is a bit hard to remember. So let's change it. As you can see, if you're using a weak password, then check this tick box to confirm to use a weak password. I recommend you to set a strong password if you're setting up WordPress for your website. For me, it's just for testing purposes, so I don't mind having a weak password. Next, you have to enter an email. Now, let me enter my email. Finally, if you don't want search engines like Google, Bing, and Quant to add your website, then check this box called Discourage Search Engines for indexing the site. After you have completed everything, click on the Install WordPress button. Yes, finally the installation of WordPress is completed. Now you can go to the localhost and see your website. If you did not understand anything, feel free to use the pause and rewind button. Also, comment down below and I will help you as soon as possible. Tell me how is my new intro and outro. So I will keep bringing new high quality videos like this one. But you have to do me a favor. Please share this video to your friends because that helps me grow and bring you more qualitative videos. That was it for this video. Please like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this one. This is Wasn't Developer, signing off.